Shemuel Aleph, chapter 25. And Shemuel died, and all Israel gathered and mourned for him, and buried him at his home in Ramah. And David arose, and went down into the wilderness of Paran. Now there was a man in Maon, and his work was in Carmel. And the man was very great, and he had 3,000 sheep and 1,000 goats, and he came to be shearing his sheep in Carmel. And the name of the man was Nabal, and the name of his wife Abigail, and she was a woman of good understanding and beautiful, but the man was hard and evil in his doings, and he was of Caleb. And David heard in the wilderness that Nabal was shearing his sheep. And David sent 10 young men, and David said to the young men, Go up to Carmel, and you shall come to Nabal and greet him in my name, and say this, Long life and peace to you, and peace to your house, and peace to all that you have. And now, I have heard that you have shearers, now your shepherds have been with us. We did not put them to shame, and not a speck of theirs was missing all the days they were in Carmel. Ask your young men, and let them inform you. So let my young men find favor in your eyes, for we come on a good day. Please give whatever comes to your hand, to your servants, and to your son David. And the young men of David came and spoke to Nabal according to all these words in the name of David, and waited. But Nabal answered the servants of David and said, Who is David, and who is the son of Yishai? The servants, who are running away from their masters, have become many nowadays. And shall I take my bread and my water and my meat that I have slaughtered for my shearers, and give it to men coming from who knows where? And the young men of David turned around on their way, and went back, and came, and reported to him all these words. And David said to his men, Each one gird on his sword. So they each girded on his sword, and David also girded on his sword. And about 400 men went with David, and 200 remained with the baggage. And one of the young men informed Abigail, the wife of Nabal, saying, See, David has sent messengers from the wilderness to greet our master. But he scoffed at them. But the men were very good to us, and did not put us to shame, nor did we miss any items, all the days we accompanied them, when we were in the fields. They were a wall to us both by night and day, all the days we were with them, tending the sheep. And now, know and see what you should do, for evil has been resolved against our master and against all his household, and he is too much of a son of Belial to speak to. Then Abigail made haste and took 200 loaves, and 2 skins of wine, and 5 sheep made ready, 5 measures of roasted grain, and 100 clusters of raisins, and 200 cakes of figs, and loaded them on donkeys. And she said to her servants, Pass over before me, see, I am coming after you. But she did not inform her husband Nabal. And it came to be, as she rode on the donkey, that she went down under the cover of the hill. And there were David and his men, coming down toward her, and she met them. And David had said, Only in vain have I protected all that this one has in the wilderness, so that not a speck was missing of all that belongs to him, and he has repaid me evil for good. Let Elohim do so, and more also to the enemies of David, if I leave one male of all who belong to him by morning light. And Abigail saw David, and she hastened to come down from the donkey, and fell on her face before David, and bowed to the ground, and fell at his feet, and said, On me, my master, let this crookedness be on me. And please let your female servant speak in your ears, and hear the words of your female servant. Please, let not my master regard this man of Belial, Nabal, for as his name is, so is he. Nabal is his name, and folly is with him. But I, your female servant, did not see the young men of my master whom you sent. And now, my master, as Yahweh lives, and as your being lives, since Yahweh has withheld you from coming to bloodshed and from avenging yourself with your own hand, now then, let your enemies be as Nabal, even those seeking evil against my master. And now this present which your female servant has brought to my master, let it be given to the young men who follow my master. Please forgive the transgression of your female servant, for Yahweh is certainly making a steadfast house for my master, because my master fights the battles of Yahweh, and evil is not found in you in all your days. And if a man rises to pursue you and seek your life, and the life of my master has been found in the bundle of the living with Yahweh your Elohim, then the lives of your enemies he shall sling out, as from the pocket of a sling. And it shall be, when Yahweh has done for my master according to all the good that he has spoken concerning you, and has commanded you to be ruler over Israel, do not let this be a staggering and stumbling of heart to my master, that you have shed blood without cause, or that my master has saved himself. And when Yahweh has done good to my master, then remember your female servant. And David said to Abigail, Blessed be Yahweh Elohim of Israel, who sent you to meet me today. And blessed is your good taste, and blessed are you, because you have kept me this day from coming to bloodshed, and from avenging myself with my own hand. Nevertheless, as Yahweh Elohim of Israel lives, who has kept me back from doing evil to you, if you had not hurried and come to meet me, not a male would have been left to Nabal by break of day, for certain. And David received from her hand what she had brought him, and said to her, Go up in peace to your house. See, I have listened to your voice, and have accepted your face. And Abigail went to Nabal, and see, he was at a feast in his house, like the feast of a sovereign. And Nabal's heart was glad within him, and he was exceedingly drunk. So she told him not a word, little or much, until morning light. And it came to be, in the morning, when the wine had gone from Nabal, and his wife had told him these matters, that his heart died within him, and he became like a stone. And it came to be, in about 10 days, that Yahweh smote Nabal, and he died. And David heard that Nabal was dead, and he said, Blessed be Yahweh, who has pleaded the cause of my reproach from the hand of Nabal, and has kept his servant from evil. For Yahweh has returned the evil of Nabal on his own head. And David sent and spoke to Abigail to take her as his wife. And when the servants of David had come to Abigail at Carmel, they spoke to her, saying, David sent us to you to ask you to become his wife. And she arose, bowed her face to the earth, and said, Here is your female servant, a servant to wash the feet of the servants of my master. And Abigail hurried and rose, and rode on a donkey with 5 of her female attendants. And she followed the messengers of David and became his wife. David had also taken Ahinoam of Yisrael, and so both of them were his wives. But Shaul had given Michal, his daughter, David's wife, to Palti, son of Laish, who was from Galim,